arrived into Iraq and wanted to try and get to Mount Sinjar. So along our journey to do that, we crossed into Kurdish Syrian territory. This is the sort of first camp that a lot of the refugees made it to, and it was, you know, really dire situation. The temperatures in the summer were incredibly high, you know, 40, 45 degrees, and a lot of these people had walked huge, huge distances to get here. I mean, the women and children just massively dehydrated, very limited medical care, just trying to survive and escape. A lot of fear as well.
Right, well, that was before, that was some months ago. Now you've been back, and the Peshmerga, the Kurdish fighters, have managed to push the ISIS, the Islamic State, off the Sinjar mountain. And what did they find? This is an astonishing image of an improvised explosive device factory on the roof of a building. How did you come across that?
The Peshmerga have pushed right to the outskirts of Sinjar town, which is, you know, past the mountain. So the mountain is pretty much clear now. And all along the route, there's houses like this. Some of them they use as a base, this one in particular. And came across just hundreds and hundreds of mobile phones that had been taken apart and modified to be used as IEDs. And is it something that are killing more soldiers and refugees than anything else at the moment? They can access them a long time afterwards by just phoning them, and they explode.
What's the future for the Yazidis now?
I think there's hope for a future there, but I don't know how many mass graves and people were killed. So I think it will take a long time to recover and rebuild a normal life there.